have come and gone since I first heard it told how Jesus would come again someday. But if back then it seemed so real, then I just can't help but feel how much closer is coming is today. And strife on every hand, and violence fills our land. Yet some people doubt that you'll ever come again. But if the word of God is true, so don't lose hope. Soon Christ Jesus will descend.
And the lawyers,
his name was Jesus.
Well, who did you say was a teaching the lawyers?
His name was Jesus.
Tell me, who did you say was a teaching the lawyers?
His name was Jesus.
Well, Jesus is that mighty teacher's name. Say was a healing the sick folk.
His name was Jesus.
Tell me, who did you say was a healing all the sick folk?
His name was Jesus.
Tell me, who did you say?
time for tears and for trials, when it's my time to carry a heavy load, when this old heart of mine starts to tremble, then it's my time to call on my Lord. When it's my time to be talked of unkindly, when it's my time to be criticized, when the whole world is falling around me, then it's my time to call on the Lord. Oh, there's nothing like the sweetness of Jesus being near.
Nothing like His presence to dry my every tear,
when this old heart of mine starts to tremble, then it's my time to call on my Lord.
Said I was proud to have my name up over the door. It was some 2,000 years ago, as I recall, located in Jerusalem, across the street from Pilate's Hall. I thought I had everything anyone would need, and folks would come from miles around, regardless of their creed. I didn't think I had but one thing that I couldn't sell, and that was over in a corner on a shelf, three old rusty spiked nails. Then one day a Roman soldier came through the door, and as he walked up to me, it seemed that he shook the floor. I said, "Can I help you, sir?" in a voice that I guess seemed frail. He looked at me with a sneering grin and said, "I want to buy some big nails." Three old rusty nails is all I have. "That'll do. For the job I have, three's enough. Now how much do I owe you?" He placed the money in my hand, and I was glad to make the sale. But then I wondered, and I asked him, sir. What can you do with three nails? Did you ever hear of a man called Jesus the Nazarene? You mean the one that goes about only doing good? That's him. Today I intend to show the world who's boss, for with these three nails, I'll nail Jesus to the cross. I stood there numb. You'll never know just how I felt. I said, please, please, sir, don't do that. As on my knees I fell, but he just turned and walked away, and I got up and followed him. I said, please, won't you let me bow back? But he just turned away and grinned, and in the distance I could see the howling mob. Through tears that fill my eyes, away with him, crucify him. I could hear their angry cries, and over the top of all that noise and groans of agony, I could hear the sound of that old hammer and that big Roman soldier as he nailed my Jesus to a tree with three rusty nails. They nailed Jesus to a cross, and his blood washed my sins away.
Soon I'll come to the end of my journey, and I'll meet the one who gave his life for me. I will thank him for the love that he gave me, and 10,000 years or more I'll reign with him. Started 10,000 years, we've just begun.
The battle's over,
and the victory's been
won.
10,000 years,
and we've just begun.
We'll just begin to sing love's sweet story. It's a song that the angels cannot sing. I'm redeemed by the blood of the Savior, and 10,000 years or more I'll praise his name.
Praise his name. 10,000 years, we'll just be started. 10,000 years, we've just begun.
The battle's over.
And was guilty with nothing to say. And they were coming to take me away. But then a voice from heaven was heard and it said, let him go, take me instead. And
I should have been crucified.
I should have suffered and died.
Oh, I should have hung on the cross in disgrace, but Jesus, God's Son, took my place.
A crown of thorns, the spear in his side, and the pain should have been mine. The rusty nails were meant for me, yet Christ took them and let me go free. And I should have been crucified.
I should have been crucified.
Oh, I should have suffered and died. I should have hung on the cross in disgrace, but Jesus, God's Son, took my place. And I should have been crucified. I should have suffered.
His plan of salvation freely bestowed on all men. Oh, what a wonderful Savior. Oh, tell me the story again.
Tell how the King of all ages willingly laid down his life there on a hill cold and dreary. He freed me from sin and strife.
Oh, tell of his name. heaven and where is he? Another city for him. Oh, how my heart thirsts to hear him. Tell me the story again.
Why don't you tell me more of Jesus and his love? Why don't you tell me more of the power of his blood? Why don't you tell me more of how he died?
Why don't
you tell me the story
again?
Why don't you more of Jesus and his love? Why don't you tell me more of the power of his blood? Why don't you tell me more of how he died?
It was a cold day late in December as I sat there in that lonely room. A day I guess I'll always remember. We knew that Dad would be leaving us soon. He closed his eyes. It's over. I'm sorry, were the words of that kindly old nurse. You can wait here in the room with him if you'd like, and I'll go and call for the hearse. I sat there in that room for an hour that seemed like an eternity. The old clothes Dad had worn laid there on the bed, and with tears in my eyes, I picked them up and held them close to me. The only thing I found in Dad's pockets that day was an old thimble he used in his trade. You see, Dad was a preacher and a tailor and worked hard until his eyesight began to fade. I held that old thimble in my hand, and in memory there I could see the years gone by, how Mom and Dad had worked to feed and clothe our little family. Dad would work all day and preach at night for very little, it would seem, but just to raise a family in the house of God was really their only dream. I remember how they worked to build the little church. They called it our house of prayer, and I thought of perhaps a thousand or more who had come and found the Lord there. Dad would get up and go all hours of the night to pray for those who were troubled or ill. He'd work hard and sometimes take the last dime that he had and pay someone else's bills. I thought of how I would go to him when my heart would be with trouble torn, or have him patch an old pair of pants that had become threadbare and worn. As I heard that old hearse stop outside, I knew that Dad would soon be gone. It's gonna be a lonely place without him there around our little home. But you know, I have something here in my hand that will stand as a lasting symbol. A thousand memories tucked away in Dad's old worn-out thimble.
on a hillside that overlooks life's sea. When my soul is tossed, it sends out a light that I might see. And the light that shines in darkness now safely leads me home. If it wasn't for the lighthouse, this ship would be no more. Everybody that lives about us says tear the lighthouse down, 'cause the big ships don't sail this way anymore. There's no use of it hanging round.
But my mind goes back to one stormy night when just in time I saw the light. Was a light from that old lighthouse there upon the hill.
I thank God.
Where the pastures are green every day. And the love of the great shepherd reaches for me when I go astray. Though my sins were like crimson, Jesus spread them like wool. Now my cup runneth over. Life is joyous and full, and I can rest by the